Please be seated. It's my pleasure to welcome you here this afternoon to Rinn Lake College, and congratulations, graduates. I'd like to make a few introductions. To my far right, Randall Crocker, board member. Brian Doris, board member. Eric Black, board member. Dr. Kelly Stewart, guest speaker. To my far left, Jennifer Tarantino Linson, representing the Academic Council. Mackenzie Trader, student trustee. John Cabot, board member. Randy Rubenacker, board chair. And Lori Ragland, vice president of instruction. I'd like to put a special thank you out there to our security for escorting everyone in and out and making sure that our campus is safe for our students and our staff year-round. So thank you, gentlemen. I told the group earlier, college is full of fun statistics. There's 43,560 square feet in an acre, and our maintenance crew takes care of 80 acres of lawn, flowers, and trees to make sure that this educational institution is of the highest quality for the students when they come here. So thank you to the maintenance crew. One of the finest faculty and staff dedicated to these graduates and every graduate that comes through this institution, worried about their education, spending hours trying to better their lives. Would the faculty and staff please be recognized? It's my pleasure to introduce our guest speaker today, Dr. Kelly Stewart, a 1979 Rinn Lake College attendee and graduate, actually on the inaugural team of the girls' softball team here, a three-degree graduate from SIU Carbondale, the inaugural class of Illinois School for Advanced Leadership. She has been a superintendent, principal, athletic director, in fact, the first female athletic director in the River to River Conference, an assistant principal, a teacher, and a coach. Currently, she's not only been an assistant professor for the curriculum and instruction at McHenry University, but a keynote speaker in over 20, and now I can say 21, events since her retirement in 2015. Trainer for the ROE 21, 20, and 23, excuse me, in 13. Administrator Academy trainer for ROE 21 and IASA teacher and principal evaluation retraining. It's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Kelly Stewart.
Well, before I get started, I have to do a thank you. I have to thank McHenry University and Dr. Dennis, our president, for allowing me to be here, because as I speak, they're also having graduation at McHenry. So I'm really happy to be here, because our graduation's out on the lawn. So at 1 p.m. right now, I would be in this on the lawn for over an hour. So I'm really happy to be here with you in your air conditioning. So do I have any Benton High School graduates that would have graduated in 2017 or 16? Raise your hand. Yeah, ha ha. You thought you weren't going to have to listen to me at graduation, and here you are. Because I retired, my last speech was 2015. So I'm like a bad penny, I just keep showing back up. So it's my honor to be here. One of the things I didn't list, but I'm very proud of, is I'm one of the interim superintendents at Mount Vernon Township High School right now. Very proud to be associated with them also. It was an honor for me to be here. It's a privilege. At Benton High School, when I gave speeches, I never wanted to give the same speech twice, so I was always looking for material. I was out looking for something for Honors Night once, and I ran across a blog from a gentleman that you wouldn't think you would look for leadership and success tips from necessarily, He's a weightlifting coach, and he runs a fitness center in Indianapolis, Indiana. But his name is Mike Robertson. It's Robertson Training Systems and weightlifting coach in Indianapolis, Indiana. I just said that. And I read his blog that was on May 7, 2013, and I took his five things of success, five factors of success. The good news is you can control every one of them. I took that and I added to it. So I want to share those with you today, and I hope it's a message you can take with you moving forward. Factor number one is mindset. You know, I think it was Ford who said, whether you think you can or you think you can't, you're right. It has to do with mindset. What is your mindset? People that don't have the proper mindset think things like, I've just got bad genetics. I'm not cut out for this. I'm better than they are. Why'd they get that? You know, Dr. Carol Dweck from Stanford University is a psychologist, studied mindset, and she came up with the theory that there are two kinds of mindset. You can either have a growth mindset or you can have a fixed mindset. A growth mindset embraces challenges, persists in the face of setbacks, sees effort as a path to mastery, finds lessons and inspiration in the success of others. Now, the fixed mindset's different. The fixed mindset avoids challenges, gets frustrated and gives up easily, thinks potential is predetermined, takes criticism personally, and feels threatened by the success of others. We all have growth and fixed mindsets on different things, and maybe even on different days. But some of those things probably rang true to you as I was reading them out. Maybe that sounds like me. Well, here's the good news. If you don't have a growth mindset, you can get a growth mindset. Because according to the book, The Brain That Changes Itself, it's all about neuroplasticity. And the brain can change. You can teach yourself to have a growth mindset, if you so choose to do. I need you to have that growth mindset to be successful. Successful people have that growth mindset. When you get older, you'll look back and there'll be people that went to high school with you that you thought were really smart and may have gotten really good grades, and they don't make it in life. But here was a guy that may have even made C's, but man, really had a growth mindset and really had the next thing I want to talk about, grit, and that person was successful. I think it's having a fixed mindset that holds people back. If you want to move forward in life and just be a happier person, you need to have a growth mindset. There's a concept associated with that called grit. And a researcher by the name of Angela Duckworth talks about grit and defines it as the perseverance and passion for your long-term goals. Simply put, when you get knocked down, do you get back up? And here's the key, folks. It doesn't matter how many times you get knocked down. The question is, how many times do you get back up? That's the key. John Maxwell talks about a concept of failing forward. We're all going to fail from time to time. We need to learn from it and move forward. That's what successful people do. I was fortunate in that my father told us a long time ago that there are two kinds of people in this world. He said, I'm going to tell you this, it doesn't matter how much money you make, how good looking you are, how smart you are, how funny you are, how whatever you are, life is going to knock you down. Life is going to kick you in the teeth. I hope you haven't experienced that yet, but you will at some point in time. We all do. So when you get knocked down, there's two kinds of people. There's the people that stay down, and it's all, well, it wasn't my fault, and somebody else, and I didn't get any breaks. And there's the people that get up and dust themselves off and go right back at it. I need you to be that second kind of person. Every time you get knocked down, get back up. The second factor is work ethic. You know, some people want the easy route. They want the quick fix, the magic bullet. Well, people that are successful understand that if it's worthwhile, it takes effort. If it's not worthwhile, then it's probably pretty easy. But anything worthwhile takes effort. And Thomas Edison said, opportunity is missed by most people because it comes dressed in overalls and it looks like work. In addition, successful people do not shy away from making decisions. Roy Vandam, the author of Take the Stairs, gives an analogy about how making the hard choices in the beginning leads to greater long-term success and results. You see, Roy Vandam's from Colorado. And Colorado is one of the few places where they have mountains next to a plain. So it's one of the few places that you would see a buffalo and a cow. Yes, is she going to talk to us about buffaloes and cows? Yes, she is. And they watch these animals, and how they react to storms is very different. You see, a storm will come rolling in from the west, and the cow sees the storm and turns east and tries to outrun it. Well, the storm just catches up with them, and it increases their pain and suffering. It prolongs it. You know, people tend to do that. As humans, we tend to do the same thing. We try to avoid challenges. We try to take the path of least resistance. We try to run from the storm. But successful people understand. They have this key insight. They understand that problems procrastinated are amplified. Waiting makes it worse. So I need you to be like the buffalo, because when the storm comes rolling in from the west, the buffalo sees the storm, turns, runs right at it. So they run through the storm. So it lessens their pain and suffering and agony. They face the challenge head on. There are always going to be storms in your life, difficult things that come up and challenges. Most try to run away from those difficult things and challenges. I need you to be the buffalo. Turn and face them. One more thing that he says about hard work is don't get too comfortable. He says when he thinks of hard work, he reminds himself to become comfortable being uncomfortable. Once you think you're there, that's when you'll start to slide back. He mentioned earlier that I was in the Illinois School of Advanced Leadership. I did that two-year post-doctorate program in my last 5 years of being a superintendent, knowing I'm going to retire. And some people said, why in the world are you doing that? You got a contract that takes you through retirement. I said, because it's getting too easy. I needed to challenge myself. If I'm not moving forward, I'm moving back. There's a concept in the book called The Power of Positive Leadership by John Gordon. It's a 1% rule. Every day, we try to be 1% better than the day before. And that's not much, is it? But man, that piles up over time. I challenge you to challenge yourself throughout your lifetime to grow and learn and get better. Don't settle for status quo ever. Factor 3, dedication. Work ethic's important. There's no doubt about it. You need a healthy dose of that. But a lot of people can be all excited and be all in for the short run. Folks, even I'm on a diet January 2nd. Now, that's funny. You can laugh about that. The question is, am I still on a diet July 2nd? You know, could I hang in there when it got tough? Or was I just there when it was easy and I was excited and the motivation's there? To be successful, you're going to have peaks and valleys. You've got to have the dedication to stay for the long run. Let me tell you about success. Success is never owned. It's only rented. And the rent is due every day. Every day. Factor number 4, you need a supportive team and surroundings. You got a pretty good start, don't you? Look around here. There's your supportive team and surroundings. Part of the reason you're here today and going to walk across this stage is because you had the support and the love and the backing of the people that are here today to share this moment with you. However, if you surround yourself with people with a different mindset, they think that your ideas are crazy. They don't believe the way you believe. They might think you're a little weird. What's that going to do for your success when your friends that surround you think that way? People can either raise you up or bring you down. Raise you up or bring you down. In John Gordon's book, The Energy Bus, he talks about energy vampires. And energy vampires are those people that are always negative. Everybody knows one. Never had a good day, never going to have a good day, don't like anybody, don't like it. They don't like you either. When you get done talking to them, you're kind of just dragging out of the room. You're like, nice talking to you. Because they suck the air. They suck the positivity. They suck the energy out of the room, don't they? Negativity does that to you. It doesn't get you anywhere. It just drags you down. Don't let any energy vampires on your bus. Surround yourself with positive people. Legendary basketball coach from UCLA, John Wooden, said, "Show me your friends, I'll show you your future." Show me your friends, I'll show you your future. Who we surround ourselves with matters. People can raise me up or people can bring me down. Now, one of the things that Mr. Roberson does that's really cool is that in January, instead of doing resolutions, on January 1st, he makes a list of the people in his life and asks himself two questions. Are they helping me move towards my dream? Are they barriers to my dream? Are they holding me back? And sometimes people hold us back. If they do, if you answer that question yes, then you've got to take a hard look and make a hard decision and distance yourself from them. People can bring you up or people can bring you down. Surround yourself with people with the same goals and are positive. The last thing I want to talk to you today about is intrinsic motivation. This is simply the fire that burns inside. Do you have that fire that burns inside? Is there something that makes you tick? Is there something you're passionate about? We have to find our why, our purpose. We're better in life, we're better employees, we're better all the way around if we can find our why. See, it's your why. If you have a why, when all you want to do is stop, your why will allow you to take one more step. You have to have your why. I teach in the doctoral program, and one of my students asked me to come talk to her undergrad class in education. First question they asked me is, "Dr. Stewart, what's your why?" Man, that's an easy, that's a big old softball pitch, big one coming right down the middle for me. Because I've known my why, it's why I do what I do. It's why I got depressed when I thought I was going to retire and going to be done, because I wasn't done. It's why I still work at McKendree and probably will never be totally retired. My why is because my grandparents were Russian immigrants. My grandparents came to this country because they were starving. Because they're in this country, my dad got to go to Benton Township High School, where he got an education and got to play football, where he then got to go on to the University of South Carolina and be a starter for 3 years, get a college degree, come back to Benton where he could coach and teach. Then his kids were successful. Two generations from starving immigrants, I stand here with a PhD. Why? Because of public education, because of Benton High School. Because when you think of education being the great equalizer, we think of that, oh, that's an old idea. It's right here, folks. It's talking to you right now. And I have a moral obligation to make sure it continues to be that, that every kid that walks through the schoolhouse door is only limited by their ability to and willingness to work hard, that public education stays the great equalizer. That's my why. That's my passion. That's what allows me to keep going when all I want to do is stop. So if you don't know your why, you need to find it. Your why will pull you up when you feel like you don't have the strength to get up anymore. Your why will keep you fighting when everyone else thinks you're out for the count. It's your why. Who are you fighting for? What drives you? What's that fire inside you, your purpose, your why? Find it. As I said before, I want to come back to grit. So I have a video clip I want to show. In closing, I'd just like to say, success doesn't happen by chance or luck. It is your attitude, hard work, dedication, positive environment, and passion. I am so honored to be here with you today. Congratulations on this great milestone, great achievement in your life. Thank you.
Class of 2018, we are all here today because of you. Your parents, your spouse, your children, other family members, your friends, your instructors, all of us here from Wren Lake College are proud of your academic accomplishment. And now it is time to receive your diploma. Will the candidates for the Associate in Arts degree, the Associate in Science degree, the Associate in Engineering Science degree, and the Associate in Fine Arts degree please rise? This year, there are 596 graduates with a total of 1,070 associate degrees and occupational certificates being awarded. Wren Lake College, by virtue of the authority vested in it by law, and upon recommendation of its faculty, is pleased to confer each of you the respective associate degree for which you have been recommended with all the rights, privileges, and honors appertaining thereunto. Candidates, please be seated. At this time, Mr. Randy Rubenacker, the chair of the Wren Lake College Board of Trustees, will present the diplomas to each individual as his or her name is announced by Jennifer Tarantino Linson, Vice Chair of the Academic Council. Will the first row of candidates please rise and come forward for the presentation of diplomas?
Tyler Gray. Nicholas Hunter Goffinet. Nicholas Freeman. Jacqueline Cheyenne Fowler. Sandra Eversall. Alicia Doris. Daniel Martin Dent. Alicia Dawson. Taylor Coggins. Karina Danae Connor. Carson Elizabeth Carell. Robin C. Brzezinski. Jacob Ross Burkett. Emily N. Beulah. Courtney Bradham. Colton Bond. Kathleen Sharon Bowling. Kaylee Lynn Beckenich. Sierra Christian Ann Beaumont. Madeline Balakani. Jonathan Liddell Armstrong. Caitlin Marie Allen. Ashley Allen. Alexandria Helen Marie Kubiak. Stephanie Lane. Blake Miller. Isaac McPhail. Brett Allen McCarty. Constance Sierra Rain McCoy. Matthew Louts. Andrew David Lingle. Ashton Cabot. J.C. A. Katowski. Sydney Paige Kelly. Jacob Kelly. Dalton Kelly. Brianna Kelly. Kyle T. Keeneth. Jade Jones. Jeremy P. Johnson. Haley Ng. Cole Robert Hutchins. Trevor James Hood. Taylor Nicole Hood. Taylor Leanne Hinkle. Madison K. Hewitt. Peyton E. Hayes. Blair Elizabeth Hall. Casey N. Halbin. Sierra Beth Yulding Tiberin. Jonathan Andrew Swisher. Hayden C. Swain. Jordan B. Spurlock. Raymond Smothers. Randy Smith. Brianna Smith. Danielle Seitz. Catherine Elizabeth Hsu. Shelby Dawn Sharp. Kaylee Nicole Scott. Ann M. Rogers. Ariana Rice. Chase Jordan Regenhart. Amber Nicole Reese. Darylyn Price. Jordan Pike. Bradley Dwayne Phillips. Kayla M. Parks. Carmen Parks. Teresa D. Page. Caitlin Morris. Andrea Nicole Morgan. Maddie Leah Miller. Stephanie Lynn Zeem. Reagan Lee Yates. Barbara Jean Williams. Chelsea R. White. Caitlin Paige Weiss. Casey L. Webb. Sydney Watkins. Brittany Lynn Ward. Alec D. Vineyard. Alyssa Lynn Van Zandt. Heisley Tucker. Michaela Trogolo. Michaela Tyndall.
Graduates, please rise. This day marks a great milestone. In addition to receiving the degrees conferred upon you today, you have earned the right to be associated with a distinct group of individuals, the alumni of Rinn Lake College. The College Board, Administration, faculty, and staff wish you all the best as you continue on your journey. Congratulations, graduates. You may now move your tassels. In respect and honor of our graduates, we ask that the audience remain standing and in place until all graduates have exited. Please rise for the recessional.